The brain is a very complicated thing, so we won't be diving into too many specifics. I'll give you a high-level overview of how aromatics can influence our emotions, and we'll touch on a few main ideas. The olfactory system, the system that makes smelling possible, is a group of structures made up of several key components. Let's highlight just a few. The olfactory epithelium is special tissue inside the nasal cavity. The cells in this structure are specifically designed to interact with aroma molecules. This is where the molecules of what you're actually smelling are first detected. We also have the olfactory bulb. The olfactory bulb is a neural structure that sends information collected by the olfactory epithelium to the brain. And that's where the limbic system comes in. Our limbic system is made up of structures in the brain that help us regulate emotions, memory, and more. Typically, the aroma comes to the amygdala first, which acts as kind of a switchboard. This is the reason why emotion is so often tied strongly to scent, because the amygdala is where we process our emotions and our primitive reflexes. From the amygdala, signals are sent out multiple other areas of the brain, such as the prefrontal cortex and the hypothalamus. Prefrontal cortex is involved in our behavior and our executive functions, things like decision-making. And the hypothalamus is a control center for our autonomic responses and even hormones. Many other signals are being sent and other brain structures are being activated. But the end result is that we get a systemic effect throughout the body. Because of the olfactory system's direct connection to the brain, our sense of smell can actually influence how our bodies feel and react in certain situations. In other words, epigenetics can be affected by aroma. We'll talk about the power of this in just a moment. Now, keeping in mind that our complex brains are pliable and the expression of our DNA can be positively altered, what are some things we can do to positively support mental health? The foundation of this is in taking good care of our bodies. The best foundation you can build for mental health is to fuel your body with nourishing foods, keep yourself active, get good quality sleep. Once you've got the physical aspects of well-being taken care of, you can focus on keeping your mind healthy. Just as your body's health impacts your mental well-being, your mental health impacts your well-being on a physical level as well. It can even have a strong effect on your DNA itself. Here's what the researchers from the Institute of Neuroendocrinology at the Rockefeller University have to say about it. The brain is a biological organ that changes under acute and chronic stress and directs many systems of the body that are involved in the short and long-term consequences of the daily experiences of living. What does that mean exactly? It means that things like stress can change our brains, which in turn affects our entire body system. Over time, these effects manifest themselves in our body, and some can even be passed along to our children. Contrary to what you might think, the ways in which your genes express themselves doesn't become set in stone once you become an adult. Even in adulthood, your gene expression in your cells continues to change as you have different experiences. For brain cells, this property is something that's referred to as neuroplasticity. And the changes in your gene expression can affect your health in either positive or negative ways.